For the first time in my life, no matter where I go, my first thought is, I'd rather be home. And that's a really cool feeling. We spent about a dozen years just getting ideas for how to build a home that would nurture generations of the family and also tread as lightly on the earth as we possibly could. You know, reclaimed 100-year-old beams from a building in town that was getting demolished, and trees don't grow like this anymore. These are former members of an old growth forest, like they need to be cared for and honored. And so we designed the porch around them. They came up with this really cool way to kind of mount the screens on the outside. They're really unobtrusive. I mean, you don't know that they're there until they come down, which, by the way, is a great party trick. I think living outside to the extent that it's possible is really healthy. In the winter, if you throw open all your windows to get that feel of it, then when you decide you want to be warm again, you've got to close your windows and you've got to either burn fossil fuels to heat the house, or you've got to go build a fire in the wood stove, and it takes time. Whereas having an outdoor space like this, it's kind of an outdoor living room. You can close the glass doors, keep the rest of the house warm, and having a screened porch allows the house to be the size we need it to be without having an interior square footage that would be, I think, greedy. So the idea of being able to consciously create a home and a space. Like, I think we've all learned about how vital it is to have a home that's rejuvenating to our spirits and that helps us to feel connected. I think I'm past the point in my life, if I was ever in one, where cities bring me peace. You know, I'm sitting in literally my favorite place on earth.